Hey there, everyone. Hope you're having a fantastic Saturday so far. Temperatures have been a little warmer this afternoon than the last couple of days, but we're enjoying a lot of sunshine. The view right now from Regent's Field looking fantastic with that blue sky out there. And we'll see that sunshine with us, dry weather as we head through the evening hours after sunset. Temperatures starting to drop, and it'll be pretty comfortable as we go through the nighttime hours. So here's a look hour by hour at our forecast. Through the evening, 74 degrees at 8 p.m., dropping down to around 70 at 10 o'clock tonight. Then the rest of the night, likely through the 60s. Many of us will start tomorrow morning either in the upper 50s or lower 60s. So another very comfortable start to the day on Saturday. But tomorrow afternoon, add another degree or two to those temperatures that we're seeing out there for today. And we'll get a high in the upper 80s in most spots. Still mainly sunny, still dry for our Sunday afternoon, so outdoor plans should be just fine. Some areas west of I-65, we're talking Tuscaloosa, maybe Fayette, Lamar, Marion counties, Pickens County, Green Hail, could top out around 90 for tomorrow. Looking ahead though, as we go through the next several days, what do the morning lows look like? Well, if you like the cooler weather, you're not going to love this upcoming week, and that's because the humidity is actually going to increase, and as that happens, those nighttime lows will not be as comfortable as they have been for the last few days. Still really nice Sunday morning, but look at Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday mornings, those nighttime temperatures only getting down middle to upper 60s because of that higher humidity. This, climatologically speaking, the fall season is our driest stretch of weather in central Alabama. So it's no surprise that it has been dry and it looks to remain mainly dry over the next 7 days. Small chances for rain in the forecast. The drought monitor starting to increase that dryness. Most areas are seeing that yellow now develop, and that's the low end of the drought monitor spectrum. But if these dry weeks continue through the month of October, which again is one of the driest months of the year, really across much of Alabama, we likely will see that drought monitor worsen. So something to keep in mind. There again are some changes coming in. You saw that dry air in place. Again, we'll back up here. Look at tomorrow, that area of blue and purple, that's still very dry air that's in place. So we're not expecting any rain for Sunday. But as we head into Monday and Tuesday, look what happens, the moisture increases. So as that occurs, throw in some weak disturbances, we will have at least a chance for some showers to develop as we go through the upcoming week. Monday, more so likely Tuesday, Wednesday, those are probably our best chances for rain. Maybe a few showers left over on Thursday. Now, I talk rain, but it doesn't look like the overall rainfall totals will be all that impressive. So likely not doing a lot to help the dry stretch of weather that we've seen. Most spots probably only picking up at most a half an inch of rain. Many areas picking up less than a quarter of an inch, and some other areas may not even see a tenth of an inch of rain as we go through the upcoming week. So just something to watch, chance for some of those showers out there. But again, the overall trend favors mainly dry weather over the next 7 to 10 days. So you see the low temperatures, they're increasing as we go through the middle of the week. Daytime highs come down a few degrees just because of the extra cloud cover and better rain chances in the forecast. Later next week and heading into next weekend, we will see a push of some drier air returns. So the humidity goes back down, those low temperatures start to creep back down, and dry weather back in the forecast with a good amount of sunshine.